Today we're going to talk about how to connect the RepRap discount smart controller to the Rumba 3D printer board. Now, a couple things I want to explain real quick here. We have two ports over here for pins that we're going to use to connect. One is EXP1, one is EXP2. And one of the tricks to connecting it is this little black box here. That's the notch on your connector for your ribbon cable to align on here. Another thing I discovered is that EXP1 and 2, or actually 2 and 1, don't match up to the EXP1 and 2 on the back of your LCD. Also, I want to point out while I'm here that on the back of your LCD, you have an SD card reader, so you can load files over here. And on the front, obviously, we have a reset button. We have a knob to navigate, so you can turn it and push to select your menu. And then we have a piezo buzzer. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect it to the Rumba board. Okay, the first thing that you want to do is you want to get your ribbon cable to have the notch side. So I'm going to connect this to the EXP2 and line it up with the notch. Now I'm going to do the same for EXP1. And on the back side of your LCD, we're going to hook these up the opposite of what they normally would read. So 2 is going to go to 1. And you're going to use the notch connector as well. And then 1 is going to go to 2 with the notch side facing the notch. So in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. But before we do that, I'm going to connect the serial USB connector and connect the other end of the computer. Now you might hear a beep. And in a moment, I'll show you in Marlin how we're going to load it. Okay, the first thing that we want to do is we want to open up the Marlin-bugfix-1.1.9. We then want to open up the Marlin subfolder. We want to open up boards.h. Now, what we're looking for in here is board_Rumba. So we're going to copy this. And we're going to close out, then we're going to press M on the keyboard and open up the marlin.ino file. Okay, in the marlin.ino file, we're going to search for the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And we're going to replace board_ramps_14_EFB with board_Rumba. Next thing we want to search for is LCD and SD. And here's where it becomes a little interesting. Right here, it says that you can speak or display on your LCD multiple languages. So for instance, obviously default is English over here, which is right here, but you could probably also do, I believe, German. Let's see, you can do French, Italian, and probably several other languages like Polish. So down below, as we scroll down here, we have other options that we can set. We can set Japanese, Western for types of characters and accented characters, and we also can do Cyrillic, so like Russian or Ukrainian. And then of course we can do Japanese as a possible set of characters. And then right here we have SD support, so if this is commented currently, we need to remove the comments to use it, but I'll leave that up to you as I want to keep the tutorial somewhat short. Then down here, if you have problems with your SD card, You can always remove the comments as well. And then there's different types of menus that you can create if you so choose. And then we have the ability to control how fast your menus move and the resolution of your menus. And then finally, you can change the direction if you remove the comments as well. So there's many options in here. If I go over all of them, I'll be going over like 10 minutes in the video. So I'm going to try and keep it short here for you. We also have the speaker and buzzer that you can enable by removing the comments. So to actually load this particular LCD, we have to find the RepRap discount smart controller. So I'm going to do a search on discount. And as you can see, here it is. It says define space RepRap underscore discount underscore smart underscore controller. So we're going to remove the comments here. And the next thing that we want to do is we want to select our port for our particular board that's connected, being the Rumba. And then our chipset should be the Mega 2560. So to upload this, we're just going to press the upload button, which will compile and upload it for us. And in a moment after it's uploaded, I'll show you what it looks like on the LCD when it boots. Okay, now that we finished loading the firmware for the Marlin, I'm going to show you what it looks like when it boots. So there's a minimal amount of light on it, so you can see. So I'm going to reinsert the USB to show you the boot. So as you can see, it's getting ready to power up. Now it's showing the Marlin boot screen. And now it's showing your status screen for your printer. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.